Hello and welcome to the last of our films for this year's Self-Denial Appeal. This week I'll be making a call to Pakistan, which is one of our partners in mission, along with Denmark and Greenland, Finland and Estonia, Ghana including Togo, and South America East. We featured Pakistan in the 2016 Self-Denial Appeal, when Kerry Coke visited the country. Pakistan has very much been the main focus for me and Rebecca for the last 2 years, and even though our plans have changed, we still feel very connected. Today I'll be talking to Fozia Columbus. When Kerry was making an episode about education, she met Fozia as she took her girls to school. The family would have been our next door neighbours had things worked out differently for us, so I'm really pleased to be able to connect with her today. The girls have grown, and Fozia is now the core-based community development manager at Territorial Headquarters in Lahore, and she looks after some of the projects funded by Self-Denial. Salam, Major Fozia.
Oh, salam, Captain Ben.
Nice to see you. Aap kaise hain?
Main bilkul theek hoon. Aap theek hain?
Theek ho. Tik tak. Alhamdulillah. Yeah, and how are your children?
They are doing good. And at the moment, they are at home because of the COVID, the school are closed. And almost the 1 year, they are at home.
We'd be so interested to know, how has it been for the Salvation Army and its mission in 2020 with all that's gone? Could you tell us a bit about that?
When the country was locked down, that was not easy time for, especially for the poor, those who are facing difficulty to get food. But I'm glad that the Salvation Army did tremendous work within the communities. We are serving communities without discriminations. We provide food, grocery to the poor, and health and safety kits to the poor. And that really good effort and get that really good initiative by the Salvation Army Pakistan. Mm.
And how about the cause in Pakistan? How many cause do you have, roughly, and have they been able to meet throughout 2020?
We do have 132 cause in Pakistan, and more than 300 active offices we have in Pakistan. We have 43 cadets at the moment in our training college. We are not allowed to open the church, but our offices and our local offices, they connect the communities with phone or with via the social media. But our officers, they did really good work on the COVID. And we face COVID and the flood at the same time. But the churches and the NGOs and the Salvation Army, they come out from their offices, from their homes, and they serve the communities. For the personnel, our offices, they enhance their capacity building. And from the last 3 years, our 5 offices serve in different corps in UK. And 1 officer, she is working in the IHQ. And this is, I believe that for the Pakistan territory, this is good, encouraging for us.
Well, I think for us, I think it's been such a great example of the mutuality of support. It's not just support flowing one way. We've needed the reinforcements from the Pakistan territory to show us their experience, to lead in the ways that they know are successful, and just to bless our territory.
Yeah.
Fozia, tell us about your hopes and dreams for your family, your ministry, and for the wider Salvation Army.
My hope and dreams for my girls should be the good Christians, independent women, courageous women. This is my dream. My dream for my ministry, when I give myself to God and I say yes to Him, and I believe that since from that day to till now and till my death, He is always with me, and He will take me and He will guide me and He will show me the way where He will be take me. And I always say yes to Him. And the dream for the Salvation Army, for the Pakistan, through our love, our support, and our call, we will make good disciple for the Jesus Christ.
Thank you for inspiring our territory and being partners with us. And thank you for saying yes all those years ago.
Yes.
And keeping saying yes. And thank you so much for your time and your inspiration. So God bless you.
God bless you too.
Khuda hafiz.
Khuda hafiz.
Bye.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Well, that brings us to the end of our self-denial films. I wanted to find out how the Salvation Army has adapted to the pandemic. And while I've gained just a snapshot of what's happening around the world, I've been really inspired by the people I've talked to. I've heard how Salvationists and friends have been coping with a host of different crises: typhoons, cyclones, flooding, and economic hardship, along with all the difficulties that this pandemic has brought. And I've heard about the incredible resilience of communities where the Salvation Army is at work. I loved what Nana Togo said about showing love when you can't be physically together. There are plenty of challenges ahead. Poverty is widespread and the Salvation Army has limited resources. But I feel more convinced of the vital work that needs to be done. Work that is possible because of the money that is given through self-denial. Richard Bradbury reminded us that this is the Salvation Army's international self-denial appeal. We are all involved. And while each of us here reflect prayerfully on what we can give, Salvationists around the world are doing the same.